larger news, was this decision made after our Halloween conversation?
Yes, after, not because of. I appreciate your concern, but really, the most helpful thing you can do is stay out of my business.
Oh, can you say that last part?
Hey, Jeff, what's up?
What's up is closure. I met my dad, we talked things out as men. I think I'm ready to move on.
Really, in 20 minutes?
Fine. Look, I couldn't do it. I was at the front door, totally in control, and then I started thinking about all that stuff you said about messiness and threw me off my game.
You know, the irony is, after all your pestering that I deal with my daddy issues,
you're the reason I'm not meeting my father.
Or maybe I'm the reason you'll come here after all.
Britta, I... Wait. What do you mean by here?
Your dad's house, where I kinda sorta am. Happy Thanksgiving?
You really you'd this one, huh?
Okay, yes, I meddled against your wishes. And yes, I got this address from the dean. But hey, you had a moment of doubt, and here I am to help you through it. Psychology tells us there are no accidents.
Oh, really? What about car accidents, Tara Reid, or the Hindenburg? Here goes nothing. Hello, William. So, how about that? No muss, no fuss.
Jeff, I urge you not to run from the muss and fuss. Hey, fellas, let's get right into it. I think the big question on everyone's mind is, why don't I go help? I can do this. Show me on the dinner roll where you're hurt! You came back.
I'm sorry. You should take some credit for who I've become.
Okay.
So, let me tell you how I turned out, just so you're crystal clear on your impact. I am not well adjusted. And more often than not, I am barely keeping it together. I'm constantly texting, and there's no one at the other end. I'm just a grown man who can't even look his own friends in the eye for too long because I'm afraid that they'll see that I am broken. So you get credit for that.
Oh, come on now.
One time when I was in seventh grade, I told everybody at school that I had appendicitis. I wanted someone to worry about me. But when Beth Brennan asked to see the scar, I didn't want to get found out. So I took Mom's scissors and I made one. It hurt like hell. But it was worth it because I got 17 cards and I still keep them in a box underneath my bed 22 years later because it proves that someone at some point cared about me. Happy Thanksgiving, Dad. Look, you're probably feeling a very strong urge to sleep with me right now, and that is normal.
Sure.
Britta, thank you. You were right. You're not gonna get all jock jams on me, are you?
No, of course not. I left my boombox at school.
I heard your Thanksgiving wasn't much better than mine. It's the one we chose.
We never got to do something about shackles on his heart.
Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Had me at no Pierce. He's been all over me lately to hang out. It's weird.
You just want to be a part of something. Admit it. Thanksgiving softened that winger underbelly.
Didn't you have a cat named Susan B. Anthony? How'd you manage to Britta that?
I didn't Britta anything. I meant Sophie B. Hawkins.
Really? Your plan was to throw a dance honoring the singer of Damn, I Wish I Was Your Lover.
Yes. I am throwing a Sophie B. Hawkins dance. And it is going to be amazing. And when people come, they're going to be like, damn, she's straight. That's right. I'm taking it back.
You're really doing this. Look, as someone who faked being a lawyer for 7 years, I appreciate your commitment to the bit, but just admit you were wrong.
So you can say I Britted it?
Yes, of course. That goes without saying. But come on. It was a small mistake. Call this off before it becomes a full-scale Britastrophe. I coined that.
Jeff, if you don't want to come to my dance, you are free to go to the Sadie Hawkins dance, which will be happening at the same time across the cafeteria. Our school has limited venue options.
Oh, I wouldn't miss it. Oh, and one last thing. You do realize that if you call it a Sophie B. Hawkins dance, people will expect Sophie B. Hawkins to actually be there, right?
Yes. And when she comes, I'm gonna be like, I will remember you doubting me.
That's a Sarah McLachlan song.
Sophie B?
She backstage drinking Vima and counting her beanie babies?
Sorry, I can't divulge that. Stars in their privacy, you know.
But she'll definitely be here.
Oh, yeah, Sophie B coming.
So it just be coincidence that somebody posted a Craigslist ad an hour ago that says, looking for Sophie B Hawkins or convincing Sophie B Hawkins impersonator to play community college dance tonight. Very little money. It's weird how in demand she is.
Good thing we booked her early.
Did you do this?
If it's possible to make something happen by willing it, then yes.
I know it's probably impossible to read my texts without them sounding sarcastic, but I assure you, this one is as earnest as they come. Congratulations on an awesome dance. You Britted the hell out of this thing. Could you hold me, dear? Look, Professor seems to be responding to things that I don't have, so you gotta get in there and jiggle something.
He hates me. He called me broken Barbie all year.
Well, we're all gonna have to work it if we're gonna get that grade changed. Be honest. Your section sucked, right?
No way. I read an entire book on the Peloponnesian War.
Wow, you pronounced it right. Well, someone else had to tank it for us to get that F.
Someone else?
Can you keep a secret?
Yeah.
I blew my section off.
What?
Well, there was a secret Tom Waits show in town, so I did the math. There's 7 sections to the paper. Annie gets an A, Pierce buys his from Neil, so that's solid. And then you guys get B's and C's, so I figured if my section gets an F, the worst we could end up with is a C-.
So you just left your section blank?
No, of course not. I copied and pasted the lyrics to War, What Is It Good For?
Good God!
Shh!
Your friends were counting on you.
Yeah, well, that's their fault. I have carefully cultivated a persona that screams you're on your own.
That's my judgy face.
Noted. I'll make it right. I'm going back in. Into this mess.
Judgy face.
All right. I will talk to him man to man and try to get our C- back. Annie, it's the best we can do right now. Let me handle this.
It's that the damaged blonde is dating the childish black one. Well, I wonder, does anyone take issue with that pairing?
You're fishing, Professor. No one has anything against Britta and Troy dating.
And that's coming from Jeff. And we used to date, so...
Britta, information is ammo.
A little friction. That usually indicates heat.
Heat? There's no heat. If there was heat, I'd be nervous. And if I was nervous, I'd be rambling. And I'm definitely not rambling, so there's no heat. Listen, I can't do a big party. It's too much.
Oh, I see what's going on here. This is about you getting cold feet about graduating.
Shaw, I've been looking forward to graduation since freshman registration. I already got a job lined up at my old partner's firm.
Well, then let them eat cake.
It was just, I'm worried that the group might not be able to handle it. You know, emotionally.
Everyone wants you to graduate, Jeff.
But what about Abed? I mean, the stress of me leaving might send him spiraling.
Come on, give him some more credit. He's really progressed since he opened up to my therapizing. Do you remember last year when he wouldn't stop talking about that darkest timeline thing?
The one where I lost my arm?
And Pierce died and Annie went insane and he blamed it all on you throwing some dice? He has not brought that up in months.
You're right, Britta. I just need to give Abed a chance in ways.
Expert Jeffrey Winger.
I'm thinking I might look into some time I want. You know, just to settle group arguments about who misses me the most.
Oh.
What do you think?
To Jeff.